I think we're still on chapter three. An animal has decomposed too much and lost all of its value. Well, shit. I think I know exact. I was just thinking about it this morning when I was sitting in the shower. I was like, wait a minute. We never took that thing off our horse. How's everything looking sound, guys? Just let me know.
What?
Well, you know.
Any suggestions for the sugar cube problem?
Don't shock me none. I've seen worse.
Sir, I apologize.
So, hello, I guess. Time to go, boy.
I wouldn't mind running into stuff so much if I was able to, like, apologize to people and, like, blow it all over. Yeah, so I don't do sugar cubes at all. I have, like, a jar that we keep brain sugar in, and that's what we use. I don't know. That might be a British thing. Belly? Does the Queen's English still require the use of sugar cubes? All right, that's interesting. It drew a straight line. The game so far has been really quiet, to be fair.
I'm running out, Rose. Get away.
Yeah, but you guys use sugar cubes and tea, right? That's where the whole joke, one lump or two.
What do you take, Doc? One lump or two?
And then you hit him in the head twice? I just assume you guys do everything old school. You guys still have like carriages and stuff on the streets, like. I kid, I've been there. Seen your ridiculous double decker buses. What's going on out here?
Easy, whoa. Yep.
And just practicing his firing.
Hey there, partner. You interested in a little friendly competition? You a shooting man? I've been looking for a challenge and I ain't found one yet. What'd you say?
Why don't we find out?
Good. Whoever shoots the most bottles wins, okay? All right. Stand alongside me. Soon as you pull your weapon and aim, we let fly.
Go.
Oh, crap.
Yeah, guess that explains it. I'm brand new.
He hit more than me?
It's hard lines, partner. Here's an idea. What do you say we raise the stakes?
No.
Come on, come make yourself some money.
That's it for me, I think.
Well, you still lost, so I need my payment. Where the hell do you think you're going, huh? We had a deal. Pay up.
So I can choose to not pay him.
Here. Enjoy it while you got it.
Until the next round, I suppose.
If two things were unfair. I didn't have my rifle. I only had my guns. And two, I wasn't allowed to use Deadeye. And everybody knows, you can't shoot for shit in a Red Dead Redemption game without Deadeye. Game is so ridiculously beautiful. So right now we're headed out into the wilds up northwest. We're gonna meet up with one of the strangers we met with before, who is interested in doing wildlife photography. He's the guy that we helped get his bag back from that fox that took off running. You at work right now, Tweety?
Easy.
What are you doing?
Yeah.
What are you doing shooting at nothing? At work and it's boring. You'll be off soon. Before you know it. I don't think there's a better feeling in the world than getting off work. Right? Like, that's just super good. Turn that light on so we had a shadow there in the green screen. Not going at all feels better. True. Not going at all when you know you're supposed to feels better. Jump over 3 obstacles in 15 seconds. We have a brace of conies.
Come on, pal. Yep.
Is there a particular reason you're trying to commit seppuku there, of course? I need to remind myself, I got 2 things I got to do today. And this just keeps, All right. Refreshing the dashboard so I don't see you guys for a second here. Having this issue with it. Popping in and out. I can see. Hopefully that doesn't do that anymore. Yeah. This is supposed to take 11 years prior. But it feels a little bit newer.
There we go.
At the same time, you know?
I couldn't have drawn it prettier.
Hey, partner, nice to see you.
Hey there, good to see you. How you doing today? Well, you see this here? American ginseng. Take a feller from not too bad to hardy as buck in no time. Really something. Yep, you don't find this every day. Goes this in your medicine, give it some zip. Believe me.
Whatever you're selling, I ain't buying.
Anyway, I ain't gonna use all of this, so feel free to help yourself to whatever's left. You take care now.
There's an herbalist. Check him out. That's kind of cool. Alright. I just heard... Just as I suspected, he had moved off of normal toys onto something he shouldn't have had. He was eating a hair clip. So now he's in timeout. What's up, Sparks? Thanks again for all your generous bits yesterday, Sparks.
Okay, then.
Phenomenal. It was a really good stream yesterday. And where is this wildlife photographer? Cat likes to eat plastic. I get the feel, yeah. Nah, he was just chewing and gnawing on it. He didn't consume any portion of it, but... taking it away from him did turn into a game, so there's that. What's going on? Got a new horse last night. It's totally random, very immersive. It was my favorite hunting, fishing, camping spot. I'm sitting on a horse with a saddle rim fast behind me, straight into the lake. Try to swim across the lake. Up the horse. That's cool.
Whoa.
I think this is where we robbed that coach. Eats hangers and underwear, huh? Magnane into hangers, but he likes to steal all manner of clothing from the laundry room and then bolt around the house, particularly socks, as is common in dog fashion. This guy is out here. This right here is what a lot of northern Arizona looks like. You guys were wondering. Looks very familiar to me.
Yeah.
He does like chapstick too. Got the legendary bluegill. I haven't caught any legendary fish. I did hunt the legendary stag though. Could go back and hunt the legendary bear soon. Now that I got the means to.
Easy now.
Those elk were huge.
Yep.
Yo, Glorious, couple bits, healing himself just a little bit up from that one hit point you guys left him at last night. Last time. Right on, right on. Thanks for stopping in. That one of the elks over there? You know what, I forgot to do something. Hold on. And Google Chrome will not stay logged in Twitter anymore. There we go. I totally forgot to tweet. Got out of the habit of doing that. How is Glorious Bitboss if Bong dropped 10k in here? He, Bong dropped 10,000 bits after Fast Break dropped 10,000 bits. So he barely beat Fast Break Jake. So he only had like 2,000 hit points. And everybody else started tearing him apart. pronghorn. Damn it. Turns out you need a lid for the crock pot to cook, so I had to try by oh hell piss pick it up. That's too funny. Yeah, you need a crock pot for a crock pot to crock the pot. What was that? What was that? There was something in the ground. Almond bulbrush. Craft items for my horse, huh? Always in packs of three, so there's that. My health is doing real good right now. I don't know why, but it is. Wait a minute. In here no more. There's only a certain time of day to get him. Set up camp right here.
Doop boop doop boop.
Did it. Turkey. Where are my stats at? Everything's looking good right now. Craft. Got ginger ale suckers. All right, rifle cartridges, explosive, so animal fat. I need a lot more animal fat. Like, that's gonna be like a heavily used item. How long do you think it'll take to cook 3.5 pound pork shoulder in a crock pot? No clue. I have no clue. Yeah, I am not the chef. Familia. can tell you that anything cooked in a crock pot usually takes a really my knowledge. Sleep till morning. Keep my guns in good working order. That was like the weirdest weather effect. There he is.
Easy.
If that's coming from there, then it's a westerly, so... Or is it an easterly? We're fine. We're fine. As long as it doesn't pick up, we're fine.
Hello again.
Hello. Oh, hello. How are you, sir? Morgan, Mr. Morgan. I'm sorry, my nerves. I'm not quite the outdoor adventurer I thought. This is God's own country, and I feel I'm in purgatory.
I know the feeling.
Oh, I hope not.
So what you trying to take some pictures of, huh? Some more greedy coyotes?
No. Wolves.
Wolves? You really are trying to get yourself eaten.
Oh, I hope not. I left the meat over there. I thought I'd be safe, given the wind.
Yeah, sure. If you manage to attract the world's least intelligent wolf.
Well, I...
I'll stay with you a while. If anything comes, I'll protect you as needed.
You are a gentleman.
You don't know me very well.
Well, to me, you're a gentleman.
Usually, I'm worse than the wolves.
Dealings with wolves, Mr. Morgan?
Sure.
But you've never been eaten.
Not through lack of trying on their part. A while back, I helped a friend from getting devoured. Usually they are not great fans of man.
I don't blame them.
Me neither. Hey, shh. Here's one. Looks like we got company.
Yes, yes, there they are. In the trees. Don't do anything. I'm going to take a few photographs. Come on. Come on. Good boys. Hungry boys. Come on. Stay back, stay back. Can't have a man in the frame. They'd think it's staged.
Yeah, sort of is.
Look at them. Magnificent creatures.
Especially when clawing at your eyeballs.
Come on. Stay still, my beauties.
Huh? don't seem to be fans of modern technology.
On the other hand, looks like... Kept the wolves from the door. Come on. Snap out of it. You're safe.
My whole futile existence flashed before my eyes.
Yeah, they can be pretty aggressive.
What a way to... Literally a dog's dinner. Still worse things happen at sea?
Do they?
Well, I imagine. Perhaps... Wolves do better at sea. Are they good swimmers? Well, who knows? You have saved my poor, foolish skin once again.
Don't mention it.
Well, I can't begin to repay my debt of gratitude. But no, I am eternally in your debt.
I do, Mr. Mason, I do. You take care now.
And you too, sir.
It wouldn't be a Rockstar game if you didn't have a side quest filled with morons doing moronic shit.
Checking this equipment. Only my hands weren't shaking quite.
You know, whatever.
The only trophy I need is a photograph.
Wanna slice these wolves up, throw their skins on the butt of my horse. Take it back to camp.
Some time working on the mechanism. Good day to you, sir, and Godspeed.
You're a collector of pelts. I hope only in cases of self-defense.
That's really cool that he noticed, like, I was gonna sit here and skin stuff, you know?
Don't worry about me. Lightning doesn't strike in the same place, and neither do wolves.
You think that? Keep picking them up instead of. The skinning.
I know, boy. Nearly done.
Like the cleanest skinning. Ever done. Like, it's like skin's not attached to the body or something. It's just like, it's like it's a coat.
Thank you again. Fare thee well.
So, you think that photograph will come out?
I can't say with certainty, but I'm hopeful, sir. And do some good luck, no?
Carry on like this. I'm not sure you are.
Poor wolf belt. Yeah, it's because I shot him with a bullet. Heck, the bother even had an animation to take coats off is cool. Most games, you kneel and stab it for a few seconds and boom, pelt. Yeah, I mean, that's the way they did it in Red Dead Redemption 1. You kind of just, like, knelt down and blood got all over the screen and that was it. Now, where was... Where was that legendary bear we were hunting? That is a trek. Wait a minute.
Whoa.
I can probably use those fences to do my next challenge.
Yeah.
Nailed it.
Come on now, boy. Hey, guess what? Oh, you... End him here. Yep.
Is that an O'Driscoll out here? He dead. That one dead O'Driscoll right there. That bear came out of nowhere. But I'm taking his skin, boys! Holy shit, look at the size of that. Satchel space is a thing. I have no way to, like, tell me. Is there, like, a number somewhere I'm missing? Nothing tells me how much stuff I can carry. Did you see the best part of that gift, dude, is when when it goes off in the group of people and you just see a bunch of silhouettes of people. I thought it was like trash cans at first, and then when it goes off, I'm like, oh shit, that was people. She just tosses it down. Could you imagine being at like a block party and then a firework just goes off in your fucking face? Oh my god, I'd be so mad. She just blew up a crowd of innocent people. She did. She did. Oh man, it was funny.
Easy.
You know, I'm actually gonna change where we're headed. We're gonna go to, we're gonna head back to camp and see if we can, make new satchels. Gonna do that.
Hey, mister.
He doesn't find that shit funny, but I'm like, Zig gets it. Dude, it is. It's. The comedy is. There's a comedy in non-intentional but intense harm to other people, but it has to be sudden, at a like just out of nowhere it happens. Like, it has to be sudden. Like, that's so important to the comedy. But like, it has to. It doesn't have to be unintentional though, because sometimes like. So, like, two people fist fighting and one person knocks the other person out, like, sometimes that, like, that's satisfying because somebody has it coming, but it's not funny. When it's funny is when two people are, like, ready to fight, and then somebody comes out of nowhere and cold cocks one of the people. That's funny because it's unexpected, and it's sudden, and it's a curveball, and you didn't expect it, and it's fucking hilarious. It's hilarious. Like, the rogue tires are some of the funniest fucking things on the internet. Even though, like, I'm sure tons of people died in those videos. But, like, you can't just help but crack up at a tire going through an entire town and then going inside of somebody's office and taking a guy out from behind the desk. Like, it's so good. It's gotta be gratuitous, too. It's gotta be over the top. Yeah, it's gotta... somebody's gotta get, like... blown up or ragdolled. I don't know. This stuff's funny. Me and Frank Plain chat. We have a very sick sense of humor. And we just got this thing where we send each other, like, just... not, like, gross, but just really fucking weird gifts and shit. Like, all the time. We're constantly doing it. And I sent him one this morning of somebody at, like, a... some kind of like festival or something, and this lady lights a bottle rocket and she's holding it and she doesn't understand how it works, so she thinks it's gonna go into the air, and so she goes and like it just falls and hits the ground because it's like it's sparkling, the fuse is sparkling, but it hasn't like ignited the rocket yet, so she just tosses it on the ground and you're just staring at this rocket on the ground, and then the rocket fires off. And it goes into a group of something. I thought it was like trash cans at first, like a bunch of trash cans lined up. But then it blows up and you realize it's just a bunch of people because there's just like silhouettes of legs and arms and people. Oh god! Oh, this shit's funny. It's like choking a guy to death when you're trying to help get a log off of him. funny, and I can't explain why. It just did. Now, are you talking about the... talking about the recipe or the gif? I got it, hold on. There you go. Enjoy, chat.
Hey, move it!
Funny, man. X me up. This shit's hilarious to me. Just like, of all the places that Rocket had to go, of course, the biggest group of people on the street was it. Like, you can't... it's just... like, can you imagine all the people over there like, what the fuck, man? And this is when gender equality is still not a thing, because if that was a man who did that, you know his ass was getting kicked that night. But because it was a girl who did it, nobody's gonna fight. Well, maybe another chick. Another chick would probably fight her, to be fair. I don't know. I mean, I've seen fireworks go off, but like, handheld ones don't usually have that big, like, that big of a fireball. Like, they give off a lot of light. But Christ, man, that was... okay, so like, a perfect example of like... hold on, I gotta save.
You the Mourn Raiders, ain't you?
Well, you may well be.
Oh, you're done for now.
Oh, damn it all. Guess they got what was coming to them.
Jesus. Shit.
No. See, now for once, the game, I agree with it. They got what was coming to them. The game agreed with me and what I did. Alright, so, and I don't have a link to it, I'm sure somebody could find it, but like, the perfect example of like, the funny criteria for Frank Plan and I's sixth sense of humor, is there's a gif out there of some guy in some country, and I say some country because American building regulations never would have let this happen, but he's smoking a cigarette. And he walks up, and there's this, like, little hole in the bricks of the, like, sidewalk that he's walking on. And he drops the butt of his cigarette in the hole, but it goes all the way down to the sewer. And so he's just like, drops cigarette, massive explosion, and then that guy's crawling out of a fucking crater with his shoe missing. Like, just, it's so sudden. But it was just like... of course he didn't know that hole led down to a bunch of sewer gas that it was going to explode. That one cracks me up, man. That one's so funny. And it's funnier because I know he's alive, right? Like, he crawls away shocked and stunned, but he crawls away just fine. No blood. Not missing legs or anything, but... probably gonna quit smoking after that. Oh my god. That's a perfect example. Just because you're like, oh, it's this guy putting out a cigarette. Massive explosion. That's funny, though. Whatever, Zig gets it. He gets it. I do. I'm thinking about blowing my... So I got a good chunk of cash, and I've pretty much, like, bought all the guns and flinged out more guns than I feel I should need to, and... Think about blowing a good chunk of my money on upgrading the camp.
So, you're back.
Yes, I'm back.
I heard they wanted to hang you.
They wanted to, but Arthur did me right.
Of course.
Mass fire here, Arthur.
Did they ask anything about us?
No, it was just a local problem. Fella I used to know.
Okay. Well, would you please try to keep away from
Morgan, old people bring me some materials, and I'll be glad to make something nice for you.
I understand, boss.
See,
I'm sorry for being foolish. It was an old thing, and my emotions got the better of me.
Thank you.
Dutch?
See, they want perfect skins for all these things.
Boys.
Remember, you won't find something like this anywhere else.
How's it going?
Can't make anything right now.
I'm at a woman town. Was talking about voting. Women vote.
There it is. There's the gift, dude. That gift is so fun.
The right materials first, Mr. Morgan.
Boop! Boom!
Hello, Uncle.
He crawls away like, oh God! The shoe falls off at the end.
All they'll let us do is teach children, clean house, and line our backs for money. Much in the way of living. Even fancy women look sour. They'll beat us and steal us and punish us.
That's funny. That's funny, man.
Thanks, Pearson.
I have no idea.
Bring me something soon if you can, Arthur.
Animal fat. Alright. Donate for crafting.
Looking forward to seeing what you can turn that into.
Oh, provisions, funds. Okay, see, I'm starting to make sense.
Not the best quality, I'm afraid.
Just make sure it goes into the pot and not your pocket. Hopefully, this will help a bit.
Good job, Mr. Morgan.
Alright, I say we finish upgrading the camp. Even though it's gonna take out of my own pocket. Everybody online's bitching and moaning about the rest of the gang not contributing enough. What do you want, Micah? I can see. But like look here. John, poor boar pelt. Sadie, good squirrel pelt. Micah, iguana scale, 15 cents. Poor iguana scale, 46 cents. How does that work out? Bill gives a poor iguana skin for 46 cents. He gives a scale for 15. Coffee, 15 cents. And then I donate like a gold pocket watch. Not fair, I tell you.
You think they're gonna
Alright, it's time to do some upgrades. Alrighty, let's see here. Alright, we could upgrade the medicine wagon. We've already maxed out the provisions tent. We've maxed out the ammunition. We do lodgings. Got a boat to buy for everybody. You know what? So that when Reichland shows up, we're buying this boat right now. Then we'll do medicine. Medicine wagoning. Alright, now last thing. We're gonna improve everybody's tents. Still got over a grand, too. What I found was if you go into first person mode, looting is so much easier. You can look at right what you need to take. Take a look at this. Alright, what is my hair at now? It's at 8. My god, look at that beard. Those are some chops, man. Those are some chops. When we get it to 10, we gotta keep the mustache. Alright, when we get to 10, yeah, I think we're gonna do some chops. We'll do this when we get to 10. The hair tessellation I don't care for. Like the small fiber tessellation in the game, it's not super well done. It just blurs things. Okay, so if we go to outfit. My winter jacket. Montana coat. I take that off the horse. Move from horse. Alright, so that one's on the horse. Throw that hat on the horse. Okay, so we got the coat. Oh, how about a vest? Okay, 1 second. Like it. All right, so we'll save that as an outfit. I should put the more fancy boots on. And then store on horse. Horse is good. All right, so now take a look at the mini-map. Go to Hosea. Run over to our horse. We'll brush him down a little bit because I'm sure he's dirty again.
There, boy.
So dusty.
Let's get you looking nice.
Perfect.
Boy.
Oh, that's right. Put up the satchel. Where is my miracle hair growth? Tonic, there it is. Alright, there. Yeah. Now our hair will start growing again. Alright, here we go.
Selling it back to where it came from.
Why?
I ain't got a market for it. They made it. They must have someone to sell it to. Stuff look kind of lonely out here. I think we'll cut ourselves a deal.
I get you.
You and Dutch was just doing your duty when you requisitioned it. Now I'm doing mine.
All right. I should get going now. I'll leave you fellas to it. Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place. You know the way?
Yeah, I've been there. So, what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? And it's time we made a formal introduction. Like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses. All I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past it.
I know. I've seen it.
Welcome back, Sparks.
There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping them.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, but maybe.
Well, I'm sure there's money in this for us somewhere if we can get in the middle of it.
Here we are.
Modest little homestead, isn't it?
Hello, gentlemen. How are you?
What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity. I mean no harm. No harm at all. You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay, okay. She's at the house. We'll be watching you.
You heard the man. Driver? Proceed, please.
Okay, what the hell's going on? Like a glove.
What you want?
Found something. Out in the hills. Thought maybe you was in the market for it.
For what?
Some liquor.
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
The way we see it, it's ours.
Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it. Whoa. Relax, I ain't here to rob you. Oh, it seems that's easy enough. Why not do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
$1 a bottle.
You give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
Well, look on it as a reward for finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
The alternative is you get shot.
Now, who wants to get shot over a bottle or two of liquor?
Pay the man.
Pleasure doing business with you. And listen, we didn't take it. At least not without orders from...
Oh, I know exactly who gave you your orders. Old Sheriff Gray. You know what? I don't want it. In fact, sir, now you can do me a favor. There's an extra $10 if you do. Drive the stuff into Rhodes, head over to the tavern run by Mr. Gray, and give the stuff out for free.
Mama!
Hush now. I believe they call that a promotional expense.
As you wish, madam.
You boys come back sometime and tell me how you made out. Maybe we'll play a little cribbage.
All right. Next stop, the Rhodes Saloon.
Here we go.
So I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to 1,000 for them. I wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were. Especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
No, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah. That don't surprise me.
All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing dress up. You know how I feel about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Hosea, please.
I'm the clown. You're the idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe.
Hey.
Bring your lip forward. Just a bit. Squint. Oh, perfect.
What about you?
Oh, shh. You can't speak. You're turned idiot. Quite broke poor mammy's heart. There. Fenton, there. Don't get mad now.
What's up, Ars Sarson? How you doing, buddy? We have quality settings today, so should be okay to view. Ickish too, what up? Okay. Stakes were made. I am the idiot brother. I'm just gonna have to drive it, man. This thing's out of control. This game's like a movie, constantly. I've never played with my stream's HUD off so much. This game's just too pretty.
Okay, Fenton, stay calm now. For Mama, she loved you so.
Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me.
We just rode in from up north.
Hey.
Hello. Hello, I'm Melvin. This is my brother Fenton. Don't mind him. Don't madden him. He's turned idiot. Killed our mother, but it weren't his fault. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks? I bet you would. One for each of you. We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour?
Go along now. Enjoy the money. Come along, Fenton. Let's hand out the liquor.
Oh my God, we're gonna bartend?
He pour drinks fast. For the next 30 minutes, the drinks in this here bar, in this here town, are entirely free. Yeah. The only rule is that you gotta drink them. So hurry up, put old Fenton to work. Don't get him mad, though. His mama made him mad, and we buried her. Poor thing. Ah. Now come up to the bar, everybody. Come on, fellas, it's your luck.
I'll have one, Fenton.
Three drinks. A gift.
Keep them coming.
Sin will catch us all. So drink up. Don't be shy, boys. Don't be shy.
Man, Mr. Gray won't be happy about this.
Grab another bottle. Have you an opportunity?
Where
now
the
it's
your
opportunity to get hideously drunk. Come on. Come on. We got work to do, my boys. Let's
You're
go.
You're a fine man, Fenton.
Loving
fine
it.
Man. Don't live to your brother.
You, don't let him
Over here, Fenton.
Gonna buy.
John, we're in advertising. Come on in and have a drink.
That's our goddamn liquor.
An honest mistake.
Boys, get him.
Oh, what the hell? No.
Okay, so that was kind of dumb. I was running at him to tackle him, but for some reason the game decided that that would be a good time to switch the context controls from tackling a person, which I just done two times prior, to reloading the guns. No. Hosea died. Okay, so that's so stupid. Like, it's so that you guys know what's going on. I'm losing complete control over my character as soon as I turn that corner, and it's putting me into a scripted event without warning. Like, the whole time I've been able to do whatever I wanted to, and I have been in situations where two people are locked up, one guy from my gang and a bad guy, and I'm able to run up and tackle the guy off of him and beat him up and stuff like that. But for whatever reason, when I'm coming up here, it's scripting me, it's taken away all of my buttons, and the only option I have is to probably, it wants me to Deadeye shoot the guy, so. I like that there's scripted things to try and get you to do a specific thing so that a storyline plays out. I usually like that, but it's making me fail multiple times, and that's kind of like fucking the immersion of this scene. Which is not fun, that, you know, takes me out of the moment. I really like doing cinematic scenes the first time.
We run no lick around here. No more business. Good job. Ah! Be here, George.
Get upstairs quick. I see more of them.
Think you can steal from us? Ah! You're a dead man! Oh. You operated, asshole!
more of them?
Don't think so. Jesus, all this over a few bottles of booze?
I reckon it's more they don't want another gang on their patch. Ha!
Okay, pull off the road here.
All right, we're good.
Yeah. Remind me never to take up a career. What was it?
Advertising.
Yeah. You think that woman set us up?
No, I don't think so. Maybe. This place is odd.
I keep seeing those fellas.
Some local militia. Clearly not too happy to have some new competition. I'll go visit old Ma Braithwaite, see what's what.
Why?
We've been making money. The chest is filling up again, slowly but surely. Part of me thinks we just get ourselves good and lost. But we still need a lot more money before that can happen. So, for now, let me go give old Mrs. Braithwaite some of this moonshine as, well, let's call it a peace offering.
Sure.
That was fun, Fenton. We'll make an actor of you yet.
I'll go speak to Dutch.
Well, that was still fun.
So, what do you think?
About what?
The fine folks around these parts.
Oh, real nice.
Exactly. On the one side, we have got the Gray family. Scots, degenerates, drunkards, the local law. You couldn't make this stuff up. Rich as Croesus. And on the other, their mortal enemies, the Braithwaites. Moonshiners, hypocritical, both rolling, we believe.
In gold. And in the middle of it all, you got some inbred retelling of Romeo and Juliet.
Exactly.
So what you boys thinking?
We try to rob them both.
You sure?
Why not?
Because we got lawmen in three different states after us.
Last thing I want is to get us into trouble, but we need money. Now, we have the opportunity here to put ourselves in the middle of something. Ain't nobody gonna know we was here, because even without us, these fools are gonna kill each other anyway.
Okay, well, Hosea's gone back to see that Braithwaite woman.
Good. Hosea should definitely take the lead on this. I sent Sean over to Braithwaite Manor, too. Now, you can meet up with them, or join John and Javier at the Gray's place. Something to do with the Braithwaite's prize horses.
Well, how the hell did we get an inn at the Gray's place?
Sheriff Gray kindly put in a word with his father. It ain't that complicated. We gotta convince each family that we're on their side, and then we rob them both. Before they figure out it was us that done it, and not the other lot, we'll be long gone. Think of it as payback for my daddy.
Payback? I ain't in the revenge business, Dutch. Least of all for something happened a long time ago.
Well, I guess we all gotta pay for something. Now, if you will excuse me, Arthur, I got to write a letter.
Still getting a little bit more intense. Not liking what Dutch is turning into. We're slowly seeing him turn into the man that is such a problem in Red Dead Redemption 1. Still a 10 out of 10 game? I would say so, yeah. So, I mean, like, whenever you're playing, like, an open world game like this, there's a lot of glitches and bugs that you have to let go. You have to not hold it against the game. Because when you give a player infinite possibilities, that means you have to test infinite situations. And quality assurance for infinite is not possible. You can't do it. You can only do so much. And, yeah, there's some quirks here and there, and I'm kind of struggling with the controls to make sure I don't kill people on accident. But whenever I kind of grade a open world slash sandbox game like this, I kind of give it a free point in gameplay mechanics or control slash gameplay, the technical portion of it, because of what they're achieving. It's so big, there's going to be some loose bolts here and there. And if it wasn't for me kind of like giving it a free point in my technical section of my review, this would be a 9 out of 10 because it's definitely losing a point, but it gets one back because of the world, and it's so damn big. Kind of, it's impossible to make it run perfectly, so I mean, at one point my daddy was comparing this to other open world sandbox games that are filled with their own glitches and goofy shit, this isn't that bad. This is relatively glitches.
There's a spot here for you, Arthur.
Damn near killed my brother one time.
So, two quests out here. They and John Marston. I don't know why this index is always up now. It never used to be up.
But my brother always was a fool and a coward. Yellow as pissed on snow. Never could stand him.
What's they gonna do? Guts. Is that what they call Pearson?
Nora's wife lives over in California by the sea. Pathetic. What kind of a man lives by the sea? I ask you.
All right. I really like his main hat. Make our third outfit. Hat and coat, let's do a vest. Okay.